Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of FFA Gist Hub. On today's show, I have juicy gist for you from the latest album in town and the songs you should be listening to how Africa is redefining beauty, and is there something going on between Adele and Skepta? Let's find out after our introduction. Welcome back. Before I go into everything that I have to say today, remember that if you've not subscribed to this YouTube channel, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button that is right below. You can also drop your comments on anything that I say. You don't have to agree with me. Remember, all is fair in love, war, and fashion. Yeah, gosh, I miss saying that. Oh, we've been going through some stuff in Nigeria, but yeah, we're getting back into it. We're back, we're better, we're getting into the swing of things. Now, talking about things swinging, this week Beyonce dropped some drip drip, yeah, on social media with her latest collection in a clothing line, Ivy Park. Now, this collection is done in collaboration with Adidas, and it has been in the works since April, but sometime this week she dropped pictures on Instagram, and believe me, putting the caption drip was not an understatement. The pictures were super hot. They were dripping hot. You need to see it to believe it.
There is your beast mode.
Yeah, for those of you that don't know, Ivy Park is an active wear clothing line, so it's very sportish, very athletic, very smart. Well, thumbs up, Queen Bee. You always keep doing amazing things, obviously. Moving on from Beyonce, we head over to South Africa, where Africans are beginning to redefine beauty. Miss South Africa was just concluded this week, and a new queen has emerged. What makes her so spectacular? She's bald and black and beautiful. Her name is Shudufadzo Musida, and it's just really amazing to watch. I mean, with the 2019 Miss Universe, Zozobini Tunzi, we saw black women on low cut really like taking the stage. And I think it's beautiful that we are moving beyond the whole women should have long hair and how African women should have their long hair braided or whatever. And we had the stage where we moved to the whole natural hair phase. And I think now people are beginning to be more receptive to women cutting their hair, going on low cut. It's all the rage. Yeah. Well, but big thumbs up to her, and we're so happy that she won. And she's really a beauty. It's not an understatement. But you know, now that people, ladies with low cut are making waves, perhaps I should go for Miss Nigeria. Who knows? Maybe now that I'm on low cut, I'll just jet out, go to Miss World, win, become the next Nigeria Agbani Darego. Eh, don't say it's impossible. But we'll keep dreaming. Speaking of a dream that has finally come true, Wizkid dropped the album Made in Lagos finally on Thursday at 11:11 p.m. Very specific. But I I'm not ashamed to say it, I stayed up so that I could listen to the album as soon as it dropped, and it's a very, very good sound. When I say good sound, it's not your normal, well, what we expect, club bangers. I'll be doing bang bang didi, bang bang didi, bang bang didi, like we like in Nigeria. But it's a really kind of, it's what I call feel good music. You know, sometimes you just want to listen to songs that have really good rhythm and they get into your soul and you can vibe to them without breaking a sweat. Yeah, that's what Made in Lagos album is like. If you've not listened to it, you should listen to it. You know, sometimes we need to also be calming down. And I must say, Wizkid and Burna Boy, they've done well this year in giving us songs that are mature, for mature minds. I think right now, that is what our climate in Nigeria needs. We need songs that will make us introspective while we are having a good time. Yeah. But that's not all on good songs. Yes, if you have not listened to the Icon remix of Nobody, yeah, that you have Lakon on with Joe Boy and DJ Neptune, I don't know what you have listened to. I'm not saying this because I'm a Lakon fan and I do love Lakon, but that guy dropped some bars in that song. He dropped some bars. You need to just, I was like, oh my God. Forget it. It is better than the original. And I'm not lying. It is better than the original. Please, don't take my word for it. Go and listen to it. Yes, and musicians have been doing amazingly well, including Burna Boy. Burna Boy performed at the 15th BET Hip Hop Awards, and he performed the song Monsters You Made, which he featured the lead singer of Coldplay. The performance was beautiful, but what made it even more beautiful was the fact that he dedicated that performance to all the people that lost their lives at the Lekki Toll Gate massacre, and all his band members, his backup singers, his instrumentalists, they had shirts on that had written boldly across it, "End Police Brutality," and everything about the way he staged the performance was just really speaking truth to power and talking about what we've been going through in Nigeria. We're from the block where it rains, where we create barricades, keep our position away. That's why we strap with the case. Don't get kidnapped from your place, cause it could happen today. Not knowing how to behave, that is a sign that you may just lose your life for the waste. Your body found in a lake, you around in the fishing, I found you drowning for days. You know we come from a place where people smile but it's fake. How could they smile if you look around? They're surrounded by pain. I seen the sky turn to gray. It took the light from the day. It's like the heads of the state and comprehending the hate that the oppressed generate. When they've been working like slaves to get some minimum wage, you turn around and you blame them for their anger and rage. Put them in shackles and chains because of what they became. We are the monsters you made. So it was a very good one from Burna Boy. Burna Boy, respect, respect. We respect you. Yeah. Yes. And Adele had a very good night on the Saturday Night Live. She really enjoyed herself, making jokes about her weight loss journey and all that stuff. But while she was flying high, she actually broke the hearts of some of her fans who have been carrying rumors that Adele is in a relationship with Nigerian rapper Skepta. But please, I don't understand. How would you put think that Adele would be in a relationship with Skepta? Anyway, before I even tell you why I made that statement, she went on social media and put up a post where she described herself as the single cat lady, hinting that there is nothing going on between herself and Skepta. But everybody should have been aware of that. She has not released her album yet, and she, after the divorce, she has to release the heartbreak album before she can fall in love again. If there's no heartbreak album, there's no falling in love. We should know the way this thing goes now. We've had three albums to prove it. So please, all those wishing that she will hook up with Skepta, even though they've known each other for a while now, they've been friends even before our last marriage collapsed, but and they stay in the same neighborhood anyway, but they're just friends. nothing more for now. So keep your fingers crossed. And Adele, please, we need a good album that we can sing when we are heartbroken. We finish using Hello. Yes, and it wasn't a good week for Desmond Elliott. Mm-hmm. If you don't know, Desmond Elliott is a popular Nollywood actor who has gone on to become a politician and is now a honorable member of the House of the Lagos State House of Assembly. Those people are not honorable, and that's the truth. But anyway, what did you do? So, in the aftermath of the whole NSAS protest and everything that happened, he took the floor at the Lagos State House of Assembly and proceeded to say a lot of things that, frankly to me, rubbish.
When I went through the comments, I could not believe it, Mr. Speaker. The curses, the abuses from children. And I ask myself, is this Nigeria? What is going on? Please, celebrities, please, social media influencers, stop the hatred already. You have a means constitutionally to change government.
How do you call your peers children and then you say it is because of social media influencers and celebrities that the whole protest was blown out of proportion and all manner of things? It makes no sense to me. Anyway, I don't know whether as he was talking, though, he didn't think that people were waiting for him on social media. But the trolling began and a lot of celebrities, a lot of actors, musicians, they came out for him, from Lala Akindoju to Uche Jumbo, Davido, Peruzzi. The list goes on and on. In fact, it was on everybody's shit list. I think it got to him because he later released a statement apologizing, saying that when he went to his constituency and saw how hoodlums wreaked havoc and looted people's property and livelihood, he was really emotional on the floor and his words got away from him. Well, but we all know that the internet doesn't forgive that easily. So the trolling continued. He later went on an interview with Arise TV where he burst into tears while he was trying to explain and justify his actions. Uncle Desmond, this is what I have to say. First off, you're supposed to be one of us. You're supposed to be part of the youth. And wait, no matter what anybody wants to say, there is a clear demarcation right now. It is the youth on one side and the government on the other side. Yes. And all these things that government have been trying to do to discredit the NSAS protest, you should not be a part of it. Apart from the fact that you're supposed to be one of the youth, I get the fact that you want to represent your constituency, but in the larger frame of things, you are representative of the youth. You are also from the entertainment industry. And you know that people in the entertainment industry are, well, one of the people that are at risk, most risks of being harassed by police because of how they try to express themselves in different ways. You were supposed to understand and you're supposed to take our side. Not going there and saying social media should be regulated. The social media that you campaigned on to get into office, the social media that afforded you that opportunity and made people vote for you because they felt that, yes, this is one of our own. You go there and you're changing your tune. This is the problem we have in Nigeria. And it's why people get so frustrated. Because there is just this thing that people just feel, oh, okay, when you go into politics or when you get into power, people will change. And Desmond Elliott is a good example. Now he has become honorable whatever. And he has suddenly forgotten where he's coming from. The people that have helped him and people that voted for him and is now saying all manner, all sorts, calling his peers children. That was even the most annoying part. Children. The fact is, I know we're gearing up for 2023 and we want to make a difference. We want to vote people in that will do the work, but I don't even know how we want to vet them, because we can't afford to have people that we think are on our side and will do what is in our best interest, like Desmond Elliott, and they go there and they suddenly change their minds. Whew. When I think about this stuff, I just get really offended and it makes me upset. So I'm just going to stop here right now and say thank you for watching the show. We will be back next week, but I hear there's a new wave of COVID-19 in town. Oh, so Kemma Kinwa just said that she's recovering from COVID, and Ladipo has been tested positive for COVID-19. So please wear your face masks, use your hand sanitizer, wash your hands, observe social distancing. Please, let's not carry COVID again. We cannot afford another lockdown. This economy, you are saying so, is standing on one leg. I'll see you guys later. Stay safe. Bye.